Welcome back to Matter of Fact in South Carolina. For a small state, South Carolina has something of an outsized reputation, known for its peaches, its beaches, and its complicated history. One of the first major centers of the African slave trade in North America, on the other side of the state in Charlestown, today's Charleston, sits in the heart of the Carolina Lowcountry. More than 300 years later, the lives those enslaved people lived and the culture they brought with them on their forced journey to a new world still echoes in a community holding on to a pained but proud past. In the Lowcountry, our special contributor, Joie Chen, found the spirit and the strength of the Gullah people rising again.
Down here where the river meets the sea rises a rich history of a people who coaxed rice to grow amid the brackish waters and built a community that's endured for more than 400 years. They call themselves Gullah, a name that likely came with the enslaved people from West Africa, a name that, even today, keeps their descendants tied to this place.
What does land mean to the Gullah people?
Everything. Without land, you have, well, you don't have a place to live, and you certainly can't have food. And then there's a spiritual element to land, you know, to be able to see the forest and the trees and to watch things grow. Without land, there is no Gullah culture.
Artist Jonathan Green sees that culture in a vibrant, seemingly carefree, almost timeless setting.
Everything is about the community.
His images center on simple themes: home, harvest, and a place in history.
You can trace yourself back how far?
I can go back to probably 1830. The first name in my family is Parker, and the family that they were owned by was the Parker family.
The family name. I learned how important that is here when I lived in the Lowcountry in the early 1980s. Charlestonians and the Chinese, the saying goes, have a lot in common.
Yes, you're proud of the heritage, and you eat a lot of rice.
And sometimes we speak a language
that nobody understands.
I'll get that hole from your keys. You want, yeah. You want
to. Chef BJ Dennis is also on a mission to preserve Gullah life, but his art is on the grill.
We got our goat. We got our wild ducks.
Real Marvin there.
At the winter hog slaughter and cookout at Marvin Ross's family home outside of Ridgeville, the community follows recipes and traditions that have been passed down over generations.
Everything is all right that you did? Same to me.
What is the link to history of the community, to heritage?
It was important. I mean, the community shared with each other. If one person was growing a certain vegetable and somebody else had some type of meat or some different type of vegetable, you know, it was almost that trade and barter system. You know, you looked out for each other.
All right, what are we eating, BJ?
Cracklin.
Cracklins.
Mm-hmm.
The cracklins. The chickens, the oysters on the grill, all serve to reunite the community with its rich past. As the chef described to us in the language of his Gullah people.
Well, out here today, we namin, about the nampon bittle one thing there. So nam eat bittle food. So you about to eat food. A lot of cracking, we teat and talking like this, yeah. We crack, we teat, we talking to each other. It's almost a spiritual thing. Spiritual energy.
Ready for the next one?
Ready for the next one.
You doing things that were ancestral. Yeah, we're gonna stew them, down with some peas. It's almost you getting, I get into like a zone. You know, and I also want to make sure the food tastes good. You hold on to as much as you can.
Even just a mouthful of rice.
Mouthful of rice, yep.
It's the same spirit that moves painter Jonathan Green in his art.
I mean, that's our sanctity. That's our glue, if you will. So when I look at painting, I look at painting from a spiritual perspective. I think what it means to be Gullah is, first, it's a culture, it's a language, it's a cuisine, it's music. Gullah, I would say, is the founding cultural significance of the Southeast.
A culture seeing rebirth and new growth in the marsh grass of the Carolina coast.
Well, you're doing all right.
For matter of fact, I'm Joie Chen in the Lowcountry of South Carolina.
I ain't gonna watch you too hard this time.